Friends, welcome back to my channel. Today we will discuss a very simplest technique in switch mode power supplies, that is buck converter, buck regulator. It is DC to DC converter. It receives DC voltage and it step down the voltage to our required level and it regulates. We will see the theory and we will discuss regulator in easiest steps. If we have a DC voltage, for example I have 12 volts and apply this voltage to a load RL, it will draw current as per its resistor value, so it will produce power and it is DC supply. So it is continuous supply, it will produce continuous power in the load. But if we have some source that is providing power in this way, on, off, on, off, on, off, sometime the power is available, sometime not. And if we divide this time interval and its operation is divided into time portions, for example in 1 second, half second is on, half second is off, so it will dissipate half power. Load will receive half power in this time. We can say in 1 second, if this was providing at the same voltage level, this was providing 1 watt, it will produce 0.5 watt. So its duty cycle will reduce up to 50%. Why? Because in specified time, we have 50% work. If we turn on for 10% and 90% in this time, it will remain off like this. And then it will turn on again. So the load, it will receive power for 10%. Similarly, if we turn on for 90%, 10% off, then 90% on, so the effective power it will receive, that is 90%. So this is a phenomena to regulate the voltage. If you use some variable resistor, it may be some transistor, some linear regulator, it will continuously dissipate power and then we apply to load. So we are dissipating power here to regulate the power. But in this technique, if we use any source which can deliver power in this way, or we can create such source which can create this type of sampling, so we can regulate that voltage. Here we are applying some voltage that are DC and this switch is turning on and turning off as per our requirement, and we regulate this voltage. We connect some smoothing capacitor. It will provide step down voltage which will base on the sampling time, how much percent we are providing here. If we are providing V in 12 volt, how much time we are providing duty cycle, V in by duty cycle, if 10%, so we will take 1.2 volt. V out, V in duty cycle 1.2 volt. If duty cycle is 100%, we will receive 12 volt. First we will see this example and then we will connect capacitor and we will discuss in steps. I am applying 12 volt here to a MOSFET and I am connecting a gate drive network and I am using PWM generator to generate pulses, to make samples as per our requirement. We can see across the load resistance, here is the load resistance, we are receiving these pulses. It is approximately 48% on the load and 83.9 kilohertz. This time the load is receiving this type of voltage and the total voltage being sampled that of 3.2 volt. And if I will decrease the duty cycle, we can see the voltage produced on this load resistance are being decreased. And the duty cycle is also being decreased here. When the duty cycle is 7%, we can see 0.12 volt are there. And here is 3.4% duty cycle. And if I will increase the duty cycle, the voltage are increasing here. But this time we are receiving these pulses. We applied 12 volt here to a MOSFET and we are taking output. Here we have this load. This MOSFET, it is working as a switch. How much time it will allow to turn on, it will produce power in the load. Now, if I connect a capacitor across this load, now I connected this capacitor and we can see the ripples are now decreased. Before connecting this capacitor, there were high ripples, but this time the ripples are decreased and it is charging and discharging time, and our load is now taking some regulated voltage with ripples. But these ripples are not acceptable, and if I will increase the duty cycle, we can see the capacitor is now charging at more voltage. This time the switch is turning on and we are providing these pulses here to the capacitor and it is now smoothing. But this capacitor will not work properly because it will receive surges. It will draw more current for charging and fast charging, fast discharging. For that purpose we need an inductor here that is called critical inductance. So this inductor, when it will receive pulse, it will produce inductive reactance XL. When we place inductor here, when the pulse will start to rise, this current will start to increase linearly. Why? Because this inductor is now providing inductive reactance. So magnetic field will start to build up. When this will build, it will oppose to flow the current. I will connect this inductor. It is not a proper inductor for this design. To do experiment, I will use this one. I will connect in the output of this switch here, and we will connect across the load. Now we can see the inductor is behaving like this. So it is resisting to increase the current, and we can see the voltage are now dropped. When we are not connecting this inductor, we are receiving 6.37 volt. And we have ripples. But when we add this inductor, now we can see the result again. This time the voltage are dropped and the high amplitude ripples are now decreased. These are now in millivolts. This time this inductor is working as an inductive load. When it will receive pulse, this end will become positive because this end is positive, this end is negative. This will become positive and this end negative. But when this MOSFET will open, at that time this end is negative and this end will become positive. To take a useful function from this inductor, a diode is connected here in this path. What will happen now? When this switch is on, the positive voltage will pass through this inductor and this inductor will give inductive reactance and it will create magnetic field. When this switch will off, this magnetic field will collapse and it will provide reverse polarity voltage which we provide from this switch. Now this end is negative, this end is positive. Before this, when the switch was on, this end was positive, so this diode was reverse biased. At that time the current was flowing from this path. But now when this switch is open, now this is invisible. We have inductor here, this end is now negative and this end is now positive because magnetic field is collapsing. So the current from this path will flow. Why? Because this end is negative, negative is connected to cathode of this diode, so it is forward bias. So positive, it will charge the capacitor. During charging, it will resist the current flow. When this switch is off, it will create voltage to run the load. So we have two flows. The first flow from the battery, the power source, from the DC source, and when this switch is off, the diode and this inductor, these will provide voltage to this load. It is called freewheeling diode. Let's see the timing diagram. We have MOSFET here. When the gate pulse is here, it will provide voltage to the load and current will increase linearly. Why? We are adding inductor here, so it will create magnetic field. When the magnetic field is expanding, it is providing its inductive reactance. At that time it will resist the flow of electrical current. But when this switch will off, this magnetic field will collapse because this current flow is stopped now due to opening this switch. Now we need a diode to connect in this path. Let me connect this diode. It is cathode. Anode we will connect to the ground and we will connect output of the MOSFET switch, which is connected to inductor, we connected to diode cathode terminal. We can see the voltage now 2.7 volt. Before this the voltage was 1.9 volt. Why? Because this current was just only passing to the load. Now we are adding diode here. So this diode will also come in circuit to provide the voltage created by this load. Now check the voltage, 2.7 volt. Now we have two sources. So load will receive this current. Inductor will allow linear current. In the off time, magnetic field will collapse and we will receive reverse voltage across the inductor. So the voltage produced by this inductor will take path from this diode. So we will receive the same path, same current flow in the load from here. In the off period, this inductor will drive the load. So we are dropping the voltage when the duty cycle is 0, 0, no voltage. When I will increase the duty cycle, at 4% we are taking 0.36 volts. Now when the duty cycle is increasing, we can see the voltage are increasing here and the level on the oscilloscope, and we are receiving smooth voltage. When this inductor was not present, diode was not present, we were receiving pulses on the load and capacitor was not present. So these three components are regulating the voltage level, and these are compensating the switching. At 23% we are receiving 1.2 volts, 64.5 kilohertz and 30% duty cycle. When I will increase the duty cycle, we can see the voltage are being increased here. This time our this PWM generator is feedback free. We are not providing any type of feedback. If we have a feedback network here, which will sense the voltage from this point, if we have a feedback network, some error amplifier which will provide the voltage level to this PWM controller, so that it will adjust its duty cycle automatically. So if we will place small load, it will give regulated voltage. If we will add some higher load, so that will also stabilize the voltage, it will regulate the voltage. So this time I am using manually. If anything which we connect feedback from here, from the positive terminal to the PWM controller IC, so that it will adjust the voltage automatically. This time we don't have feedback. If we have feedback, it will regulate the voltage, so it will compensate the load effect. If we will connect some high load or low load, it will regulate the voltage, its standard voltage. As this type of professional regulator, it is working here. We provide voltage and we connect load. We adjust the output what we need. After that, it will regulate that voltage which we need. For example, we are providing 12 volt here, we need to take output 5 volt, so it will provide 5 volt within that current limit. This regulator, it is not providing any type of isolation, because we are just sampling the voltage and we are providing to this regulator network, that is inductor, capacitor and a freewheeling diode. So this inductor, it will drive the load. Why? Because in on time it will store the energy, and in off time it will run the load using its stored energy. I hope this video is informative. If it is informative, hit the like button. If you have any question, please write in the comments. Thanks for watching. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.